You are welcome once again. We want today is a workshop on using SPSS. For the first day, second day, third day, I believe that the first day will open your eyes, the second day, you know, to be open more, but it's third day you have confidence in using SPSS. Just a minute, let me pause the video. So let's quickly look at the objective of the meeting. To explore the key windows in SPSS, define variables and entering data with SPSS, Excel, and Excel, and also convert data in SPSS to Excel to SPSS. You know, screen, clean data, sort and split file, explore data for normality of distribution, explore data with graph and compute and transform data. So these are the objectives. And yes, because most of what your expectations are, these serve as the foundation. Because in our training, we're going to see a series of training. Starting with the commonness and the commonness and statistic we do carry out chi square, official exact test, calculating odd ratio with the confidence interval, relative risk, then go to comparing mean t test, then the non parametric counterpart of t test. No t test about comparing two means, comparing more than two means, ANOVA, the non-parametric counterparts of ANOVA, regression, good linear, logistic, Poisson regression, then survival analysis and cost proportional hazard regression, even many like that. Now, for you to be able to benefit maximally from those training, because when you do it, we run it, it's 60 years or 30 years ago that people struggle, you are solving mathematics, you are using R. Now it's computer. So that is why learning statistics is not by using R to solve, it's by how to use computer to solve it. And that is why all those tests you see, it comes with a theoretical aspect where we demystify the logic here. And then how do you practicalize it using the machine or using the software? That's all we do. And this, if you want to use SPSS to solve all this problem, the first is for you to first of all know how to go about using SPSS. Because if you don't know how to use the SPSS, go about the window, what does it do? When we are now treating all those tests, different statistical topics, and use SPSS to demonstrate and start out. So if you don't know how to use it, you'll be lost. And once you don't practice, you forget. It's practical. So it's not theoretical. A lecture give you information while workshop, you are involved. It's a workshop. You are involved in the workshop. You are involved in the process. Now, let's quickly look at the timetable we want to look at in the next 3 days. We started with opening session. Opening session is all this thing we have been discussing, try to know ourselves and expectation. Then how to open the SPSS itself. How do you open it? The software, when you have it installed, how do you open it? I don't know how many of us have the SPSS installed on our computer. Sorry for, you know, normally I usually ask this question many a time. You know, by the time you subscribe, I will ask you, you have SPSS installed? No. And if you don't have, I sent version 25, the latest I have, the one I have, and how to install it. You know, it's becoming complex installing it because SPSS is the most expensive of the software. But it's because over the year, people know how to circumvent. Like if you want to buy the newest version, it's very expensive. There's some people who know how to crack. It's the oldest among them. So over the years, people know how to crack it. Then now they are making it complex for people to crack also. So this version 25 is not the latest, but at least it's not too old. But people still crack it, but the installation is not too straightforward. And that's why I send the step in for installation to Ross. So I want to find out how many of us are, before I proceed to this timetable, how many of us, you can just maybe raise your hand or indicate, you can just talk. How many of us have SPSS installed on our laptop? Okay.
Is it the one you sent to us?
Is it the one I sent?
No, I don't have. So that you have sent to me.
I sent to you now.
Yes. That's what I'm saying.
Okay, have you installed it?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
You can mute your audio.
Okay. Dr. Mati has it. That's great. That's raised up. What of Dr. Abdul Karim? Do you have it installed on your system?
Yes, I do.
Oh, that's great. Yes. What of Dr. Emesheta?
I don't have one, and I couldn't even download the one you sent.
Yeah, it may not even need
it to says not that I don't have the app or whatever to. I don't have something to download it.
No, I couldn't download on my laptop. Which laptop are you using? Which type of laptop?
Mac.
Ah, you are talking. Mac. You know this software, they have their own Mac version. You know, usually say, there's one lady among you in Loot there, at Loot. I've forgotten the name. Is it Wisdom or something like that? He has something to do with something like that. It's one of the, it's an able lady. No, sometimes just like a modelist or those. So that was how she attended her training last year. She came with MacBook. You know, the MacBook, there is different, there is window version of the SPSS. We have Mac version. And you cannot install the window on it unless they partition it for you. They now partition it, one side window. You can use it, can now install SPSS window. But there's SPSS map, but all these car coins, they are a window. So you can go and buy the Mac version or SPSS, and they will store it.
Sir.
You can buy it, but it may be expensive. But otherwise, if you want to install this one, you may have to partition. And that one has risk, it's like 50-50. Some people, if they don't know how to partition, your computer can crash. That Mac can crash. So it has happened to maybe one or two people I know that they did that. So it may be something dicey. So this map is fizzy. It's like using your money to buy liability because it's not compatible with most of the things we are using. So that's why I don't like it. Yes. Yes.
Hello, sir.
Dami.
Yeah. I have SPSS, but it's version 23, I think.
It's okay. No problem.
Okay.
It's okay. All right.
Thank you.
Yes, it's only Deborah doesn't have. Yeah. She will have installed it today, but she traveled. So no problem. Maybe before our meeting of tomorrow, maybe she'll be able to install it. So let's continue. So we'll look at exploring the key windows. Also define variables and entering data with SPSS and Excel, converting data in Excel to SPSS. By tomorrow, we'll look at sorting data, summarizing data, that's descriptive statistics, then collapsing continuous variable into groups. Now, sometimes you have age, how do you put it on the table, how do you arrange it? Not only age, any or continuous variable, you may want to tabulate them, then splitting data. And most of the time you do comparative study, two groups, three groups. How do you, if you want to run it together, so how do you do that? So that's splitting data. Then we have exploring data for normality. That's what's quite interesting. Everyone now, is it normally distributed? That's what they're saying. So how do you explore that? And how do you transform? Because when it's not normally distributed, you may take one of three the one of three alternative decisions. You may still go ahead to do non-parametric tests, rely on the robustness of the test, or you decide to use non-parametric tests, or you decide to transform the data so that you can still use the parametric test. So how you do transformation, we look at it. Computing new variable from the existing one. You know, when you say hypertensive, somebody is hypertensive. There's nobody you get from the field directly hypertensive. Yes, the way you do it is, you have history of hypertension, the person is hypertensive, one of it. You measure the blood pressure, it can be systolic hypertension can be there. It may be diastolic. So those three things you combine together to say this person is hypertensive. How do you create that new variable from the existing one? Or when you say hemoglobin concentration, you see the cell there. How do you say anemia, create anemia out? That is using computing new variable. And many other things, BMI. All you need to measure on the feed is height and weight. You don't analyze, you don't need to use computer calculator to do it and begin to. Somebody did it when I was in Lutz. I think you suffer yourself. See, this thing took time. You know, calculated on his paper, calculated who sent you. So it's because he didn't know that running data analysis, you can do that. Using Boolean logic to select cases and create new. This one is the most important, as far as I'm concerned, because many people, that logic, they don't know. And the funniest thing that in my endeavor in life, I discovered that logic. That way is a common sense. You think common sense. It's not common. So that if somebody cannot think logically, and that's not the only way to think logically anyway, but it's one of the ways. So using Boolean logic. So that is what differentiates a small child in statistics and an adult in statistics. So people they call guru. Sometimes they know the emotional intelligence in that area is high. And we'll talk about it, and we demonstrate the Boolean logic. And those are I think by the time we go through this, your expectation will be met. I'm not saying that by the time we do this one, you cannot analyze your project. No, you cannot. You have to build on it to analyze your project, because this one is just all the different tests you do will not do it yet. It's just a foundation. With this, if you try to explore and begin to, you'll be able to use it, knowing how to use the SPSS system. So that is the beginning. So that's so because I was a trainer, we wanted to do this training, was president. If I had that, I would like to be able to do the analysis, use it for anything. And that's it. How many hours training? How many days training? So just like you do workshop on surgery, one particular surgery. And that's it. I will be able to. That workshop, we say, I was able to do the surgery now. And maybe now you carry your husband to operate alone on that thing. It will be dangerous. But let's start. I've stopped the screen now. It's going to be interactive. So those people that say, okay, let me first of all open my demonstrate. You mute yourself, Dr. Mesheta. I don't know what is causing this echo. But if you have question, raise hand. Raise hand, I will allow you. Please can stop me anytime. This is not lecture where you allow a person to, or speech, where you allow a person to finish. Stop me anytime so that you don't miss out at all. So it's meant to be interactive. So let's start. Now, there's no way I can share my screen without, first of all, I will just click on SPSS icon. If I click on SPSS icon, from there, I can share my screen. Because if I want to share screen, there must be something, window. You're like, at least open. You're like, if you want to open something, even just to open where the folder is, before you share, you'll be able to share it. If you don't do that, you won't be able to share anything on Zoom. Then, one thing with SPSS, I don't know. Somebody says using version 23. For version 25, I don't know if it starts with 23. You don't even need to go and open SPSS. If you have a folder SPSS file, not folder, file. You have SPSS, maybe you have entered data, or you have seen, you may even enter the beta and say file, SPSS file, you have on your computer. Just go there and double click. When you double click, it will open SPSS for you, the SPSS, and open that data set. You need to go to AutoSend. Let me just first of all demonstrate. Let me click on my SPSS icon and show you how it looks. Let me quickly share it as it's opening up. Can you see? Oh, sorry, it didn't just, let me share back. Please, I want to, if somebody can see, somebody can just tell me. Once somebody, one person can see, every other person will see. I want somebody to just volunteer, you can see. Can see my screen. Unmute yourself and volunteer. If you don't, unmute yourself.
Yeah, yes, I can see your screen.
You can mute that. So you can see the screen. When you click on the SPSS icon, now we are not talking of installation now. So that one, leave that one, so that we don't waste time on how to install it. It has been installed. You know, when something has been installed, you either have it on your start bar or the icon on your start bar or on your tax bar. The start bar is the bar that usually have where you see some logo like something like flag, green, red, something. Where you click on, you can say, is it Microsoft Word, Office? Is it anything that is on your computer? You can say to click, that is start bar. But anything you open, you are working on, most of the time, it doesn't have to be, but most of the time it's horizontal. We put it horizontal. You can decide to put your taskbar inside. The way you put it, you can put it on the top. But most of the time, it's usually horizontal. When you click on it, you open Word document, any document, the icon will be there. That is taskbar. That is the task you are carrying out. Because some software, maybe something you want, you use often, you can decide to put it on taskbar. When you install it, you can right click on it, give you option. You want it to be on taskbar or on a start bar. So like my space is on the taskbar. You want horizontal, I just click on it. When you click on it, it gives you this. What you are seeing now is telling you here, the new data set. Let me put my little touch now. Spotlight. So look at this. Is it new file? Is it new data set? New data set, just leave that one. If it's new data set, now you click on new data set. But you see some, because I opened some recently here, you see recent file. Those are the one. Is there any of them I want to, if I just double click on it, it will just open that data set straight. So if it is another file, apart from this, because the most recent one, that the one listed here, you can just choose, if that's what I want to open, you just open it straight, it will come up. But if it is another, just open another, it will take you to another place. You see, sometimes you look at, there's open here. If you look at this thing, the icon is on recent file, but you can decide to click on open here. Sorry, as I open it, it stops sharing, but I will share it. You see, can you see? I just open, it just open blank SPSS for you. Now, I want somebody to just open it so that we can use, because I don't want to, you won't do it. I'll be telling you what to do. And that's what we do. Somebody will do some, somebody will do some. So somebody should click on this SPSS. If have you opened a taskbar or whatever, just click on your SPSS and share. Share the screen. Let me allow sharing. You see the green light, green icon, share screen. If you click on it, it will open all the things that are opened, your windows. What you open, you just double click on the one you want to open. So has anybody click? Did you click? Somebody should click on your SPSS icon. And once you just open the way I did it, just share with us. Can somebody do that? Nobody wants to
I've opened my SPSS now.
Go to share screen on the Zoom. Go back to the Zoom. Go back to the Zoom window. Yes, Zoom. And now click on, you see that arrow that go up, share screen. Click on it. When you click on it, you will see that you have opened the SPSS. You just click on it to open. We'll be able to see.
Yes. Yes. Okay.
Yes, it's coming up. It's coming up. Yes, okay. You can see. If I can see, everyone else can see. It's not me sharing. So you see that it's the same thing I did that Dr. Abdulkarim did. And that's all. How to open. Now, if you look at this on the recent file also. So you have opened some recent file. You can decide to click on any of them. You got that number one, the one that is highlighted, click. Is the one that we open. If you say recent file, it will open it. So open it, let's see. That is recent file. Click on that.
I should open one. Okay.
Click on that recent file. Open it. You double click on it. Okay. Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Thank you. Grace, you will see something. Immediately she opened, click on a recent a file. That is, it doesn't have to be recent, but is a file that has data. Two windows open. There are two windows. You first not see one, like as if they put this there, you not see this one. Now, we can even see your taskbar here. Is it my own? I'm seeing here. Your taskbar, if you put your cursor on the taskbar, you will see something. Put your cursor on the taskbar, on that SPSS icon. Yeah. Yes, don't click on the, yes, can you see? Is showing two of the windows. This first one you are seeing, you see output document. That is result window, output window. You believe that's where, when you click on anything, the command is written there, and the result of analysis goes there. That is the viewer, they call it viewer window or output window. Viewer. Now, the other one, that's a electronic cigarette, that one is the data editor window. Dr. Marty, are you still raising your hand? Or is the other hand?
This is my hand, though, because I am lost.
Okay, that's great. Please, if you raise her, I didn't see you talk. Yes, I'm going to talk. So that, where were you lost?
I've opened my SPSS. All I can see is that view with, because I haven't put anything on my SPSS.
Okay, don't worry.
I can just see untitled one.
Okay, Dr. Abdulkarim, stop sharing. Stop that, stop sharing. Okay. Still share it ahead. So share your own.
Okay,
Dr. Marty, share your own now. What do you want to share? Let's see.
Please, I'm coming.
You have to come back to Zoom. You have to come back to Zoom. When you come back,
yes.
Yes. And I click on share screen.
Okay, yes, share screen. Yes, this is where I am.
Yes, it's sharing
okay.
Now.
Can you see my screen?
Yes. So what you did, you are not lost. What you did was what I did the first time. You didn't open existing file. You just went to open under open. So in that case, it will open new file for you. This is new file.
Okay.
It's empty.
Okay.
Yes, I mean, it's okay. It's nothing bad about it. If you have, do you have any SPSS file there inside your computer?
SPSS file.
That is where you file that has a data set in SPSS. Do you have anywhere?
I don't have any data set. I don't think so.
Okay,
I don't think I have any data set. But the other problem, it's not a problem. The other thing I noticed is, for me, I think I have two, my SPSS, in launching it, there are two ways to launch it. I don't know how it was installed, such that once I open one of them, I just get here straight.
That's what I'm telling you. I said that if you, that's version 25, right?
23.
It doesn't matter. What I was telling you is that if you, some of this latest version, not the old one, what they have improved such a way that if you have SPSS installed, yes, you don't need to go to that icon and go and open it. You just go to okay. You go to the folder, just the way you look for normal things, your work document, your folder, where it is. Maybe you have a data set on SPSS. You know, the file will be there. Just go there without opening SPSS. You now double click on it. It will open SPSS for you and now open that data. Can you see that? Okay. That's the faster way or the fastest way. Even sometimes okay. when you want to create new one, a new file, you can go and do that. From there, you create new one. So I prefer that. I just go where it is. I don't even need to open. You double click, it will open SPSS for you. Okay, Dr. Abdulkarim, you can share again. Share that screen.
Thank you.
Welcome. Yes, thank you. So if you see when you are hovering on this thing, this one we are seeing is called data editor window, because that is where you create your variable and enter data, and you can edit your data. That's why data editor window. If you look at the icon, the data editor, the row there. Now, you see SPSS data editor. Can you see up there? Look at the icon. See that SPSS data editor. Let me put my annotation, my spotlight. Okay, something is coming up for me. Okay, you can see here. You see where I mark now, statistic data editor. Can you see? That's data editor. Where that place I mark up is data editor window. Now, I want you to go and hover on it again. Hover on it, on that. Sorry. Please pay attention. Go and hover on the icon. Dr. Abdulkarim, over on the icon again. Down now on the icon, you did, the way you did that. Click on that first one, the one, the result window. Click on it. Can you see that? It's showing us. You can expand it. Can you see that? This is where, this is, you see? Yes, thank you. This one is viewer window. That's where the result go to. So both of them, if you go back to over now, from this over, you can click on the other one back. Can you see? That's how to. That is one way, or let's say the fastest way of moving from the two windows. But the other way is, there's an icon window. So we are still going there to talk about this window. Leave that one. I will still talk about it when I go through all those windows. So now, this SPSS data editor window, you will see there are two places there. We have variable view and data view. You are in data view. Click on the variable view. Can you see? This variable view, you know, it's just like data are values of variable. That is, age is the variable. But you are right, 29, 37, those are data. Sex is a variable. Writing male and female, those are data. Height is a variable. Writing 1.73 meter is data. They are writing, those are values of variable. So you know that when you go and collect, you say you are collecting data, but you are collecting the values of variable. For the data, you have to have your questionnaire where you say age, you put the value there. Sex, you put the value there. Ethnicity, you put the value there. My occupation, you put the value there. The height, you put the value there. Have you heard of hypertension? You put either yes or no. All those things, they are the variable. Well, what you are putting in are the data. So it's the same thing when you are using SPSS. This one is something like your questionnaire, where the questionnaire, that's what we call the questionnaire file. You are typing age, your sex, all those things there. While in the data editor in data view, put on them there, data editor window, just variable view of data view. On the data view, that is where you enter. If the height is 1%, that's where you enter. If the sex is female, that's where you enter. Can you see the difference between them? And you see that if you look at the variable view now, you will see that horizontally is different variable you see. So if you will, you know, Dr. Marty gave some number and I explained the variable under label. But what I just want you to know, we still get there. What I want you to know right now is that in the horizontal line is the, in the variable view, each horizontal line belongs to each variable, one variable. So you see that if you look at it, serial number is the first, and it should be the first. Never ever enter data without serial number. What we are saying that even if we are even using, I know now you can use app to, you know, mobile to collect your data on tablet.
Excuse me.
Yes, go on.
I can't open this. It's not opening.
Who is talking?
Dr. Bolanle Uzonwa.
Okay, what is not? Oh, stop sharing, Dr. Karim. Stop sharing. So what is opening that is not opening?
When I let me share my screen.
Okay, share your screen. You can override our own sharing, okay?
Okay. This is what I'm seeing.
Okay. Okay. Yes, I think the problem there is that, you know, you say you reinstall it today, right?
Yes.
Yes, you didn't install it very well. Not all the feature is there. If you look at that, if you have installed it very well, you will see that those icons, the name of each something will be there. And that was why you saw the step for installation I sent. Did you see?
Yes, I did.
But you didn't use it. You have installed before I sent the step, or you didn't go through the step.
I used it.
No, there is a cache at the end. There is at the end, before you close it, you will see this. That you are supposed to uncheck something. Okay. You know what? You can stop. Let me just take through. You can stop here. Let me go and open. Let me go and open that in the step in installation, because these ones are very, very important. Don't say that. That's not, it's very, imagine you say, you know, and I say, okay, come and open a brand. Dr. Bolanle has gone for training on SPSS, and you want to, you can give us a few minutes just to explain this thing you are talking about. And you cannot open. You cannot open it. You know, some of those simple things you must be able to. So like, I will share something now. So it will at least give us some clue about the problem you had with that installation.
Sorry to button, sir.
Okay,
I want to take permission just for a few minutes just to say my prayers. I'll be back.
Okay, yes. Somebody said this thing. Whenever you can, you have, it's good, tell us. What we do is that we now do some general thing. Within 10 or 15 minutes, we do some general. When you come back, we'll proceed. So anytime we are doing something like that, we give the allowance for the Muslim that want to go and pray. So just within 10 minutes, where we will not be waiting, but we'll be doing, we'll not progress, we'll be doing some other thing, asking questions, clarifying issue before you come.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir. I'll be back and I'll let you know once I'm back now.
Okay, now that's fine.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So sir, was the crack I copied though.
The crack, but you paste it where you are supposed to paste it.
Yes.
Yeah, there's something I believe you missed. Don't worry. I will share the truth with you. And most of the time, that's where the problem initially is. There's something I believe you missed. Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir.
You know, these are the step I gave. So if you follow it like that, as you are following it, you follow all these steps, right?
Yes.
Yes. I will show you where you probably made mistake. Many people make that mistake towards the end of it. Okay, before this place, all these are the other. You can you see this one? This step, step eight.
Yes.
This step eight, you will see that start SPSS. If you look at what I wrote, uncheck the box in the front of start SPSS. This one.
Okay.
Let me spotlight it. This start SPSS statistic, 25 license. You know, it's checked, it's marked. You uncheck it. You have to uncheck it. You didn't uncheck it. That's so.
Okay.
That's where the mistake is. So when we have to uncheck it, when you close it, that's where all these other ones will be able to work.
Okay.
Yes, that was the reason.
Okay.
Many people will check it. So you after this today something you do it. So by you uninstall the one you have done. Just uninstall it and go and do that. You see that it will be very straightforward.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Okay, welcome. Yes, while waiting for Dr. Abdul Karim, Dr. Abdul Karim to come back, let's just repeat what he was doing. Let me just repeat what I've said before. I think I opened my own spaces. Yes, you remember I opened this blank space before. You see, Dr. Bolanle, you see that, can you see the difference between your own and this one now? Because your own does not give you all this file, ID, view, data, transport.
Yes.
It's because of that. So it's not complete.
Yes.
Yes. Because of that.
All right. I'll do it later. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, welcome. Now, just what we said before. This is blank one. Nevertheless, you see, if you come to variable view, you see number one, two, three. It just tells you the number one, you for each row, you put each variable, just like what Dr. Abdulkarim was showing. You put each serial number. I've already said serial number should be number one variable because the reason is very simple. If you are doing research and you enter, you didn't even try to serialize your art, that is your questionnaire, to put that mark on it, number one, number two. Even if you have put number one, number two, before you go to the field, and when you are now collating, you know the one that go to the field that come back. You said the one you want to enter, you want to use, you have to renumber it again. And it's the new number you want to use. You must, if I'm entering 300, 350, you must put number on it serially. And that creates the first variable as serial number. So that as you are entering it, you are entering the serial number. Imagine somebody adult, we are talking of adult. You run your analysis, you just summarize your age, you now saw that one age. When you run this one, you now see 187. Adults, there's no adult that will be 7 years. So, yes, human being can be 7 years, it's a child. Adult will not be 7 years. It may be, is it 37 or 37 or 70 something? There must be when writing it, whether you miss the first figure or you miss the second figure, something happened. How will you now trace it? If you have not serialized, or you can trace. You have to be struggling, going through. You can see tracing, but it will take you hours. And it's very laborious. But if you have serialized it, even when we say tracing now, it's for you to go and trace the paperwork, the questionnaire paper, the which one, the seven that I put that there. You see how difficult it's going to be. But if you have already put serial number, all you need to do is that when you search, even if the thing has scattered, when you search, you just say, You sort that particular variable age, sort ascending or descending. When you sort, we are going to do this part of what we're going to do. You will see that seven, you it does come out first. If you sort ascending, since it's the smallest value, it will come first. You'll be able to trace horizontally which serial number. Questionnaire 291. You now go and look at that questionnaire, check the paper, you now see that the thing is 37. The Euro 7. Can you see that? That's how to make the college. So if you are not done, much more than that, a lot of things you can solve. So you never enter data without numbering. That is just the rule. Now, we assume the first variable will be serial number. Any other variable follow. So the variable is on the horizontal, but on the vertical axis for that variable view are the characteristic of the variable. the variable you want to, what is the name? The first of the type as by numeric or string. We talk about it as we are going with decimal, label, many things. Those are the characteristics, missing value, we talk about it. But if you go to data view, you see the that variable name or each variable that was horizontal in variable view like this, it will change to vertical. Can you see now? That variable you are typing Asia, it will be vertical. What is now horizontal will now be for each case. That is, if I'm one of your respondents, if I'm number one, so I will be is my everything about me. If you type one under serial number, sex, male, height, weight, all those things. For that first, so no matter how long your questionnaire is, even if your question is 1 hour something question or more than that, for one person, for one subject case, it will be on the horizontal, one line, one person, one subject, one line. So if your sample size is 300, that's why you are entry for 300. So any question concerning this one, just to differentiate, we are going to do it. I want the later journals. We're going to do it, verticalize it, the way it goes. It's not, there are nothing. Yeah, I want to explain something. You know, let me, here now, you know, I have open blank space now. I can go and access even the one, another, I can open another blank space through here. Just by say five. Can you see? I go to the left and right upper corner. I click on five. You see, new. You want to open new data like this? No. You want to open existing one? You see? Click existing data. So it will open for you window like this. Where you open this place? That was the last place I opened. That's why it's opening this way for me. This file, this folder, you see, matter is somebody's project. So I created that folder. That I put the data set there. So let me just click. Let me just click on this second one. As I double click now, it will open. Let me share. Can you see that? The data set. So, either you have opened blank one or existing one, you can go through it to go and open another one, just like what I just did. Now, if you look at what this is the variable view, this is the data view rather. You click on the variable, you can see this person, the way he enter, he didn't put, I have to be careful. Let me just close this data because the person sent to me, I have no opening. The first person sent the one, he has not completed. He sent this one, has completed. The person doesn't know much, he just put in data. Who can tell me what is lacking in a data set now? What is lacking? You know, this is supposed to be interactive. You can see the screen now. Can everyone see the screen? I just need one person to answer me.
Yes, sir, I can see the
yes.
Screen.
Yes. What do you think? What do you think is lacking this data set? I just opened the variable view to you. Or should I show you the data view? Look at the data view. Nobody answered me. That's what I just said. Serial number is not there. Can you see? You have gender, age, all those stuff, marital status, everything. But there's no serial number. It's a dangerous data set because anything can happen. So what I usually do this time because if you start running around, you can even scatter the data. It will arrange it. So it's better. I will create another that variable in the front, a serial number. I will now keep it. I will now put the number there, numbering there. I will call around. You enter variable, you didn't put serial number. That shows that those data data. That shows that the data set now. If you are scattered, the questionnaire, because it's not the way, if he has not arranged it judiciously, the way maybe, the if, let's say, the way he enter it, it didn't scatter in the same way. You can go back and renumber it. And here I give number according to the way he sent it to me also. But I doubt, after entering data, he would have scattered the data together. And it's not put serial number. And I told that. So sometimes to clean this type of data is very laborious or dangerous. You may not get the right thing. Let me open, I'll close our data set. I don't want. I have to, let me open another one. Okay, see the one. Okay, I can open another one through this thing. Open, not new, open data. So I can go and search another person's, but I will not go and open somebody's data. I have my own data set. I send to you. How many of you downloaded what I sent? Talk, please. How many of you downloaded what I sent? I sent the module and data set. No person.
I downloaded the one for skin lesion. Is it the one for skin lesion?
Okay, that's and right. That's the first one we're going to use. Yeah, and the module. Yeah, that's what I'm asking. That's great. Okay. Thank you for that. I just want to open even one of the data sets, the one I said to you.
Okay, I'm back now, Dr. Drew.
Okay, that's great. So we start from where we are. Okay. Now. Okay, let me just stop here for a while. Okay, I want you to share your distance. Share back what you shared the other time. Share it back. I also allow another person to share. Now, what I explained to them is, well, what we're explaining was that as you see now, the horizontal are variable. The first one, serial number, this first question, sex, age. So I will talk about the way they label this thing now, all these things. So each of the line for the variable view is each of your question. And remember, when we start creating it, I remember that you have different type of question. Anyway, or different type of variable. We'll talk about it later. Now, vertically are the characteristics of this variable. The name, the type, the width, I will explain the decimal, label, value, missing, column, alignment, measure, and row. Now click on the data view, doctor. Click on the data view now. You see the data view. You will see that the name that was horizontal changed to vertical here. What is that horizontal is each of the respondent. So number one is the number one respondent here. Is number one, enter. The person is a female, you didn't capture age. You say the person is indigo. Then never marry. Can you see college, 4 years? So all the values of the variable are along the horizon. So for one person, even if your question is 300 questions, that's how you're going to have those each of the 300 questions at 300 variables. So these are they will appear vertically like that. So for one person, so just know for variable view, horizontal is the variable, vertical is the characteristic of the variable. For data view, horizontal is the case, that is the each respondent, the vertical and the variable. The variable that was horizontal in variable view become vertical in data view. Now, I want to once you share my own now, share what that empty something. You can stop sharing. I can override it anyway. Where is this other one at? This I close it. Okay. Let me just open near there. Okay, it's because I wanted to let me open another thing. Let me open blank space now. Now, this blank space, can you see my screen? It's a blank space. Can somebody see the screen?
Yes, but it's not blank.
It's not blank. That is the HPSS. HPSS new folder, new file. There's nothing in it. Is that not what you are seeing?
No, this one has.
No, it's not blank.
I didn't stop sharing. Can you see what I'm seeing now?
Yes.
Yes.
Hey, it's blank. This one is blank. Now, let's go through this icon. Now we have already, you know, variable and data view. So it doesn't really matter whichever of the view you click. It's the same thing that is appearing. You see file, edit, data, transform, all this. Well, let's use the head. Now, let's look at this. File. Like any other things in window, file is where you just, it's like, the function is like Microsoft Word. What file does is where you, maybe you want to open, mostly close something, open, can you see, close. Though, of course, we know most of those functions also. You can do is use somewhere in a shorter format. That's what file is all about here. Edit, majorly undo, redo, just like what it does in any window. View, this is where the difference starts. Though we have view in other windows, like a window program, like Word and Excel, we have view also. But what you are doing is what different. Now, this one, I will see, explain it. I will demonstrate it practically. The view is just to see. Sometimes if you want to remove the grid line now, you know this Excel, something, SPSS is like Excel here. It has row and column. You want to remove that something, if you click on, look at this icon grid. I can uncheck it. As I uncheck, can you see now? It become black. It doesn't have that. Can you see? Can somebody see? I just need one person to answer me.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
It has removed the grid line. So, but much more than that, if I go back and return it, it will return. But there's something I will see show you about that view. Then data, from data, that's where the SPSS is concerned. In under this data, we do all sorts of things. You're going to use it also, how to split file, select cases. So if you want to choose, you know, we already said this is data editor window. So is the result view does not open because I've not created, if let's say by the time I created this old file now, I'll close and open it. Immediately, just like the one Dr. Abdulkarim did, as she opened, because it's an existing data set, it opened the two window, data editor window and viewer window. But this one is only, this is a new one we are creating. So this new one is only data editor window. Yeah, so when you say data editor, so some manipulation you can do with data here, you see come. Transformation, this is where someone, you say we are creating new variable. You want to transform from, want to do log transformation, or you want to compute, maybe your X want to make X square, the BMI, or under this place, that is where we want to range age, quantitative variable, we want to do into classes, like all this viral load now, you say less than this one, more than this one, this to this is high, this to this is moderate, this low, how do you do it? So that is where you do under transform. Analyze, major issue. All the analysis, when you say analysis, that is where you do it. Sorry, I'm on the feed and people are just calling. I will just say, just 1 minute. Okay, so let me just. Yes, sorry for the delay, for the interruption. I think you can see back now. So transform, analyze. That is where all the analysis, can you see different type of analysis? And if you click on one set, it gives you different options. All the analysis you think of is under this. Then graph, you go to plot graph. But most of the time, it is rather you don't use the graph. Number one, the reason is that several reasons, two of them. Sometimes you may prefer other graph. You may prefer the graph in Excel. Maybe that type of graph, you want to plot it with Excel. You can export your data to Excel and use the Excel because it gives a final graph or chart. Most of them, if it is chart, you prefer Excel. But though before the graph of Express is not so, they are improving on it. Starter has better graph than SPSS when it comes to the resolution of the graph. The SPSS now, they have improved on it to meet up. Just like we started trying to meet up with SPSS in graphical user interface. SPSS has the most developed graphical user interface in the sense that the older the people embrace point and click, you make it easier to learn. But data you have to put command. They discovered that was a limitation market. People buy SPSS more. All those companies, they use SPSS more because it's easy to use because of point and click. So most of the people that prefer using data are the people that are going to academies. But the people that are doing business, all concerned them by cracking their brain. So, and they are the people that have money. So SPSS data is coming also, trying to bring point and click into it in the latest version. So, and that one, when you point and click, it still write the program, just like SPSS. So, the people don't bother to learn the program. Because if you learn the program, it's shorter, it just type, it's just doing. So, when it comes to graph, HAL has the best resolution. And somebody was asking me to the HAL, but if that one to learn it, you need programming. So you need to learn something about programming. That's why it's the difficulty in learning it, but it's fast. And very fast and best resolution when it comes to graph. Now, this graph here, that's one reason you don't use it. Another reason people don't use this under graph is that some, even as you are doing analysis, you can plot graph. There are some options for the graph. When you are running the analysis, you are replacing where option for graph come out. So you don't even need, so people, most of the time, people don't use that, this icon graph, but it's for graph. Then utilities from here now. It's just for you to see the business aspect of it, because it's not only for data analysis, a lot of things you can use. You know that just like something like a PINFUNA, a sample size calculation, many, many things. So if you explore this way, there are some other things apart from the analysis you can do. Extension, this one also talk about their product and some other things. Window. This window is what Dr. Abdulkareem demonstrated. What you can use this window to do. I will not be able to explain it. Let me stop sharing. Doctor, let me share. Do not stop sharing. Let me share the other one. That lady's work to explain this one. Look at the window. You know, if you remember, my own is not showing, is it because? It's not showing something. I'm trying to look for the. Okay. Dr. Abdulkareem, share that your screen. Share that your screen quickly. This is not showing. There's something because. You know, when you over, because we can see. Well, maybe, I don't know where we went. We can see your icon. Your taskbar. You know, when you hover the SPSS icon, is able to show you the two windows. Yes, you can pick one. But come up to that window. Come up to that window. That one I was demonstrating. You can, if you click on it, you can change the window also. Come to that window. Yeah, thank you. Can you see? You will see that the one that is checked, look at it. two electronic cigarette smoking. That is that one too. That is the data editor window where you are. The other one, output window, number one. Click on it, it will go to output window. Can you see? So if you go back, click, go to the window again. Can you see? If you click on the other one, it takes you to data editor window. Can you see now? Can you see? So two ways of changing which window you want to look at, whether you the ovary or you use the that window. So there, F, the last one is F. But I can tell you, F in expenses cannot help you. Because these people that they are business people, they are people that know that they are good at statistics, they just know they develop software. Of course, you have business sense, you employ statistician, expert, he will tell you this is the formula for this. It's just for you to know the formula, the logic, and you a programmer, you program it. The statistician that know the formula may not know the programmer. So the statistician will be there, the programmer will be there. So the statistician will explain to the programmer this. The programmer will program it. Now, in their own head, it appears it's the programmer that writes their head. So the help cannot help you. Cannot even learn anything reasonable about it. When they are talking, it doesn't even make sense about statistics. Now, the help that can help you are some individuals that are good at, and they know how to use expenses. They are the ones that write their book on how to use expenses. That one will help you, not this type of help. So it doesn't mean that help does not help you. The NVivo, that software for qualitative, the help. In fact, it's one software I know that the help. You don't even, without anybody to, if you go through the help, you know how to use. And that was what I used. It's the help I used. Because somebody gave me, they said they had a project, and when they are writing the proposal, they said they must use NVivo. And they wrote there they would use NVivo. When they started the project now they don't even know how to use NVivo. They now want someone to come and teach their staff that project how to use. They were referring to me. Me, I didn't know how to use NVivo. So I have to download every retro version. It's the help I use. And I went to train them. So after that, I trained people in Port Harcourt. I trained people in Lutz. I trained people all over. You see? Yeah. So for NVivo, want to learn them, go and get it. So I use the help. It's just a matter of you sitting down, you get it. And SPSS, the help cannot help you, but if you get good books on how to use SPSS, I'm telling you, you will learn it. Now, that is the, so those are the function of those things. You can stop sharing. Let me share back my own. The one I was with. So I'm with the blank one. So now, let's look at creating variable now. I've explained before, yes. Let's go to where we create variable now, variable view. And I want to explain this. No, we have explained the general icon file this, but I want to explain what these things are for. And with that, I want to be like creating data file with it. Name, let's say serial number. You know, we already said serial number should be the first variable. Please, if you have issue, just let me know. As you enter by default, the expressor will give you some default value for all the characteristics of the variable you created. The default value will give a thing, what they think may be the commonest for variables. They say numeric, type of variable is numeric. You know, when you say numeric, then if you click on it, you see other options. If it's not numeric, it will be string, apart from all those dollars, all those dates. But numeric, string, those are the two options. Now, numeric means that what you want to be entering in your data editor window is number. That's meaning of numeric. What's going to be entered is number. Well, if it's string, what you are going to be entered, it will allow both number and letter. Numeric cannot allow letter. If you marry, you cannot have letter, it will not take it. But it will take number. The string will take both number and letter. In SAP info, that string is what you call alphanumeric. Alpha means letter and numeric. So if you choose string, you can type where you are entering your data, you can type something like any number or any, that is figure or combination of both figure and or letter. But however, that figure you type there cannot be used for mathematical manipulation. You cannot say you are, maybe you will put your age now. You say age is string. And you type now, if you take number 76, 50, if you take it, when you say calculate, you want to run me, you do, you will see, you will not see that variable set. It will not appear because it just like it's not something you can calculate. So you can decide to use serial number as string because it just it's an identity. You are not doing anything, you are not using it, you are not calculating the mean serial number or mode or standard deviation of it. It's not, it's just identifier. You can put it there. You can use as string. But why should they put it numeric by default? Why they put it in numeric is better. It make you efficient. Make you to be efficient in using spaces if that thing is numeric. Even if it is sex, it's good to make it numeric. In the sense that I will now say, instead of typing female and male, type one and two. There's a play we now label it that male is female one, female is two. So that is just like that. Now, width. The width is when you are where? Because I said something that the width, I'll see clearer because the width and the column, I will explain the two together. One of them is the width. What number will it, that is one number of the name of that variable, what number can it take inside it? Like for example, if you say household income, if by you can change this, you can reduce it, you can increase it. Can see the way I'm doing it in that column. If you say household income, household, how many letters is household income? It's very long, maybe up to 14 or more. But if by default you put 8 or 7 or whatever, when you are running your analysis, that variable, you may see house and ish. You will not see all of them because you are limited in number you can view. Yeah. By this width. Then, when you are inside, you are trying to run analysis. So, not that you cannot type it there. You can see put CC, and when I type it, you just type like serial number now. So, I can decide to say serial number. Then, I want to tell you when you are typing, let me type another thing. 8, 6, creating. We have to go and work on the property of each day. What is it? Marital status, ethnicity. Or marital status. Marital. Now, it will not take space for you. If I say marital status, I push space now. You see what will happen. Can you see? Say variable name contained in legal character. The legal character is that there's no space. But you must put something. If I say Marita, and I put underscore status, it will take it. Can you see now? But if it will take it. If I put dash there, you know dash in our computer is minus. When you use the I use it, you refuse it for me to change to it. Because anything also that a mathematical function, it will not take it as part of the name. So no, so that some people, that's why underscore is not, it doesn't have mathematical function. But me, I don't like it like that. What I like, I just write it, no space. But I make sure the second word, the other one, will start with capital, so that you can see my letters start to read it like that. That's what I do. It takes, it doesn't allow space. Now, now talk about ethnicity. Household income, education, some of the most of the things that do happen, usually do education, occupation, household. Income. Now, the, this one, can you see, even if you put, you reduce this thing to anything, the what will happen is that you can see type it out, but when you are running the analysis, since this one is 8, also income, how many character? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So you can only tell you the first 8, maybe house. Household is, we don't even spell the old. But if you want to increase what you can see, you can increase it. You can increase this by high value. Now, the different column is like that. When you say household income, the number on the width is the number of the name of the variable that will appear. What do you say?
Please, can you describe what this width is for again? Is it for, I did not know it was a, it was related to the number of letters that you have in the word.
Yeah. The number of letters you have for the name of the variable. You understand?
Okay.
Now, that will appear, doesn't it? You can type any amount, but you want the number that will appear up to. That's what you can set it. You're like, you can change numeric to anything. Do this one so you can set it. Then the column is, when you are now entering data, notice when it's talking of the name of the variable which you created at the variable view level. But when you get to data data view, you know, for each of the variables, you want to enter something. Imagine the number of character you can enter. Imagine when you say household we call now. If you limit the thing to it, and somebody now say 10 million, how many characters is 10 million? You wonder 8. You limit the other one to 8. If you not show you, we don't be able to, you won't be able to show you up to, or allow you to enter up to that number of character. No, so the column now is about what you enter data view. The value of that variable, which is data, while the width is the name of the variable, the name, yeah, the number of letters of the name of the variable that will appear. Now, let's go to the next one, decimal. By default, you can see 2 decimal places. And I think they limit to 2 because, or they put the 2 because, common thing like height, we like to measure to 2 decimal places. So there are something like people do decimal places, do a percentage, some people use 1, some people use 2. You can increase the decimal. If you don't need the decimal, you can remove it to 0. Like that. You look at this one, a serial number, you can move to 0. Age, since the age you are dealing with, you are dealing with children where you have decimal, you measure in week or month. When you have decimal, you provide it. If it's adult, you have the right to go. You say how old are you? You say you are 47. Maybe you are 46 plus, you have it up, or you are 47 plus, you just say 47. You don't put the decimal. Since the way you calculate, there's no need. So your this you don't allow, because if you leave it there, you don't make that amount to be neat. In the sense that anything you type there, you say 0.00, 0.00. So the number of decimal you put, you allow, it will be, but if you put 3 now, 3 decimal places, and that thing does not have decimal, or 5 decimal, If you write that in 0.00000 on five places, it makes that item to be unclean. So when you don't need the decimal, you remove it completely. You reduce the decimal to zero. If you need only one, you reduce it to one. You need only to leave it as two like that. That is decimal. Label, you will notice that you remember that for the name of variable, it doesn't allow you to space. So you know there are some questions, variable that are in form of question. Have you heard of tuberculosis? Something like that. What was the first source of information? You know, some of these variables are in sentences. And sometimes when you enter your data, you want it to be as close to, so that when somebody just look at it, he will not be asking too much question. You quickly understand the data set. So you may not want to type the name on the name does not allow all those things. But this one, the label allows it. Look at this one, I just say serial number. So it allows me to space, unlike the other one. Can you see? But have you heard of this? What is your recombinant, so whatever. What is the source of information? In fact, as long as even you can even type the question there, the way the question is on your questionnaire, that is the label. If you, by the time you are running the analysis, these are the experiences, that label, what you type there is what you'll be seeing. You will not see this one. That is the label. What the, just like we are in workshop now. Okay, Dr. Dami.
Sorry, what are we using this label to do now? Oh. What's the purpose of filling this label?
Okay. Let maybe Dr. Abuskarim share. Okay, I can even share the one with me, that lady's home. I think she did some labeling. Let me see. Look at, can you see my screen? Look at the other something. Look at that lady's own. I didn't close. Can you see?
Yes.
You see, look at this question, number 8. Is it rest here one? You don't know what it means. Their own is, they just type it the way the questionnaire is. They just type something just to denote it. Like number one, number two, whatever. Under the name, short form. But for you to know what it means, look at the label. Do you know the environment can be polluted?
Okay.
Maybe under is a question. This is where the question starts from. Under respiratory, or I don't know what they mean by it. Unless you see the questionnaire, maybe the soft copy of the questionnaire, not to really know what is it, that question. It has to do with respiration here. So, and there are 10 questions there. That's why, or 11. You now put that 1, 2, 3. But this is the one that tells you about the question. What the question mean? You know the environment, you know the industrialization has negative impact on the environment. So the person, if they didn't even send a questionnaire to me, questionnaire, if they bring it now, I know what each variable mean. Because this name of variable does not allow for all this. It just allows for short. Why this one? But when you are running it in the analysis, when you are running analysis, is this one you wrote that you'll be seeing? Do you know the operation of the industry? Can you pollute? Can pollute this? Those are things you'll be seeing. And me, I don't just like it. I don't label. I just leave it, create it the way I want. Because when I create it, is that one I create that I see? But if you label it, it's the label you'll be seeing. So that's why. Even when you are computing a variable, it allows you to put label. I think it's clear now.
So, yes, thank you.
Yes, welcome. Now, back to what we're doing. So, can you see? I think that one has explained. Now come to values. Values mean this one is only applicable when you are dealing with categorical variable. For quantitative variable, when you enter the value there, so whatever you enter of quantitative variable is numeric. The categorical variable like sex now, marital status, ethnicity, education, occupation, all of them are categorical. Here now is age, household income are quantitative. numerical. So when you code all of them as numeric, that is number you are going to write there. Actually, you have to now tell us what is does number mean. For me, you see, you can say for sex. So for value by default is a known. But you want to put value for sex now. As you click on it, it gives you this option. Like me now, you see, one is me. That's what we're going to do. You create your ad. Two is female. Because one is male, zero is female. Whatever, anything you want to enter, you say this is it. Or anything that has been entered. You know why I say anything that has been entered? Sometimes you enter something in Excel. Excel format. And now Excel format now, you now import to SPSS. They have entered one, two, three, women, one for male, two for female. So from here, you now label it. What I enter there, one is for me. Many times when we do this work, I discover that any data set you see, female one, male two, is female that has that data set. Maybe they feel that how can you say female number one, all things? Because many times people will say male, female, male first, one, female two. And if you are alphabetically, F come before M. So female will come first. But so because there are some ladies just decide in their own data set to female is one and male, but it doesn't even change anything. Now, for the same thing with the marital status now, you label it because they are kind. So the label, the value here is for categorical. For you to say what each of them mean. That is, what is the value of me? What do you put there for me? What do you put for female? What do you put for single? What do you put for married? Divorce to represent. What do you put on ethnicity? Is it Asa, Igbo, Yoruba, all that? What do you put in there? That's just it. All level of education, there, of course, the level of education to be sincere with you, you know that it's ordinal scale. You range it from one lowest to the highest. But when people are arranging occupation or something, they move in the other way. The highest occupation is one. So you have to be conscious of that. When you are analyzing, for example, now, if you are trying to do some analysis where you are trying to rank, you are ranking, you are using, because education, they are ordinary variable. It's ordinary variable. Occupations is ordinary, occupational level. Not classification, rather. Not all this one, you go and write a civil servant, hairdresser. All those are rubbish because some of you now, you are all civil servants. Yeah, most of you. You are working for government, you are a doctor. The janitor is there, is civil servant also. The cleaner there is civil servant. But you are not at the same level. So there's a what we call registrar general classification to classify occupation. So when you, especially the clinician, in their own research, they just put things that have no meaning as their occupation. But for public health, you just have to do the right thing, use the proper. But the issue in that case, when you do the right thing, you have occupational, you rank it. You know, they say number one is professional. Number two is intermediate managerial. Manual ski number four, non manual ski number five, semi ski, on skill. They now put it like that. But the issue is that if you are ranking, as I want to give rank now, you may have to reverse it. Because if you want to use the analysis to rank, like the highest score should be for the one that is highest. So, like for education, like that was straightforward. No former, primary, secondary, tertiary. If you rank it like that, good. There's still some people, they introduce some other thing that may be confusing. Like if you do your research in Northwest now, you're going to see a lot of people have running education. And when you have to be careful because it's level of education you are looking at, it's not the type of education per se. That could be any education. Where does it belong? You have to decide, is it primary education or secondary education or tertiary? You must decide what that and put it as well. Because it doesn't make sense to put low from a primary, secondary, tertiary, that's a Quranic. So if you rank it, are you going to say that the Quranic education is higher than the tertiary education? So you must, that Quranic education, where, which level? The level it is, that's it. If it's primary, it's primary. If it's secondary, you put secondary, if it's tertiary, you put it. Now, that is that. I think you understand that one, you label. Now, missing value, you see something like this. You see those by default.
Sorry, Dr. Drew.
Yes.
So, do you mean that so for like that Quranic education now, is it that once you now decide that, okay, you want to use it as primary education?
You must
is the same code that is...
Yes, that's what I'm saying. If you are analyzing...
So if anybody picked Quranic education in their questionnaire, I will assume it is primary. So every time I enter the data, I enter is that primary.
You know, I say you did.
Is that what you meant?
Yes, if you decide, if that's your decision, I'm not saying it. I'm not saying Quranic education is primary education. I'm not saying you have to decide where you belong. Because
I understand.
Education is ordinary. It's not just the type. It's ordinary. Okay. We want to know the level, hierarchy. There must be a place it's for within that ladder. You understand me now?
Okay.
Otherwise, some people, when they do the code 1, 2, 3, 4, and I pay this order for an education 5. And when they analyze it, if it is going up, you expect, because if something is determined by a level of education, you won't be able to analyze it very well. If you now put Quran as, some people say vocational, they now put as number 5. Do you get a vision? So it creates problem in analyzing your, so either vocational, Quran or any other thing you have, either religious or whatever, that's something you put in one level. It's the level of education now. If you want to use level of education as an ordinary variable, but if you just want to know the type of education, that one is different. The level of education, you see religious education, the formal education, even the religious can be in the formal setting. So, so the type, that's why some people say formal, no formal, I don't know. But the issue, if you want to use education as an ordinary variable, from no formal, known, primary, secondary, tertiary. Okay. Any other thing, where they look for where they fit into. Now, missing value. Missing value by default is known. But if you click on it, you see something like this. This is something you see. You see, by default, no missing value. But you see two approaches. Even 1, 2, 3. The first one is discrete. That is, the discrete, they give 3 options. No, whenever missing value means that question was not answered. And there are many reasons for the question not to be answered or for the value not to be there. There are many reasons. It may be that it is not applicable, but they say, have you heard of this? Have you heard of COVID-19? You say no. You will not answer this question. I say, if it is yes, from where? So for this, that second question that follow, anybody that say no, it's not applicable, the other one is not applicable to that person. Of course, that thing will be black now. That is not applicable now. Now, it may be that the person don't know. You say that, what is the cause of hypertension? Or you can even say, excess too much sugar, of course, hypertension. Somebody that say yes, somebody that say no, I don't know. So it may be I don't know that is causing the blood. Because sometimes, not many people put I don't know as option, where I don't know is required. They may assume that type of question is either yes or no. But there may be just like, somebody have this type of problem in your family. When they say family history of something of hypertension, someone say yes or who told you? I told you. Somebody I don't know. I don't know if, because somebody may be apathetic, he doesn't know. He may know that, oh, there's family history, that nobody, the uncle is apathetic, the mother is apathetic. He may say, no, nobody, there's no such in our family. So, but they may say, I don't know, somebody have it. But if you, so I don't know, don't let us drag, go into some other things. But I don't know, it's an option that can make both of you blank. If you don't provide that option, you know, sometimes I usually say it may be from experience, from the time I was in Lagos. You know, when I was in Lagos as a resident, I tell you that I analyzed over 400 projects. So most of them masters, then fellowship. Then we have some few PhD projects. Now I discovered something. If there's some question that the yes or no that's supposed to happen, I don't know. And the researcher does not put it. Somebody can put viral and say, instead of thinking, no, I don't know, you put, instead of giving either yes or no, somebody can put viral and put, I don't know. And that person, if you know, most of the time, is an able person. I don't just know. He's an able person. That we, if that maybe that thing, option is not there, it will take pain to carry Bible and write it, the option that is not there. So you see, that's why it's good to do pretest. When you do pretest, you give it to people. Such people will help you. They will write it. I don't know, even if it's self-administered, yeah, you give to them. They will write you now. That shows that this I should put, I don't know, as one of the options. That's one of the reasons for the pretest, because some questions are not appropriately phrased. The interviewer, the respondent will help you, because you'll be able to see the way they think. That would be a window to what will happen on the field when you are administering your questionnaire. Now, one reason, I'm talking about two reasons now. Somebody may decide not to answer a question. That is the real no response. He decides not to answer your question. He knows you. That's a question, and you cannot force the person to answer it. You cannot force the person to answer it. Some people now, you say, how many sexual partners you have? Whether the person is married or not, even though it's confidential, the person can decide not to answer you. He has right not to answer you any question he doesn't want to answer. So the non-response, that blank something may be that. So there are many other reasons that may be responsible. Now, the people that developed software now, okay, they gave three options that, okay, the cost of non-response may vary. They give you room for you to enter values, three different values to separate it. And that values you must enter will be outside the range of the normal thing you have enter. For example, if I... You talk your age, and somebody is up to, nobody is up to 90 or 90 something in your data set or 80 something. So if there's a non-responder, that maybe this talk, the age is black, you want to put it there, you may decide to say 99, because you know that nobody have up to that. Nobody have, because if somebody have up to that, maybe somebody have up to even 100 or 120 years, 100 years, or more than 99, and you put 99. Any figure that if you now put that 99 there, and if anybody have 99 in real life, if you treat it as non-response. Can you see that? That's why you don't use it. You're like, if you want to say, maybe there's option, maybe male and female, or else, or any other thing. Maybe the option is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In your own data set, you put 7 as, even 6 as missing value. It's okay, because there's nobody that will have that value. So anything is 60. But if you have option up to 1, 5, you should put 5. As your missing value. All the 5 there, you will treat it as missing. So when you are setting your missing value, you give you three options, up to three options here. So I can type, if I want to put it and I click on this, when I click on it, I can now say this one is 99, this one is 999, this one is 999. Now, my own 99 may be, the person is not applicable. I already know that it's not applicable. You have your own code, it's not typed here, but you have your own code book. You know when you're doing that, you have coding book. That 99 means to you is not applicable. When it is not applicable, you put 99 there. 999 may mean to you, I don't know. 999 may mean to you, the person decide not to answer. So that whenever you have social number of non-response, you'll be able to divide it. How many of it is because it's not applicable? How many of these is because it doesn't know? How many of these that this one just decide not to answer? Decide not to answer you. So though the issue of I don't know, if you already imputed it, put it as part of your option, it's not applicable yet. Because if the person doesn't know, he will click that option. So I'm just telling you the scenario that makes you to use knowledge. You may not use the DC, you can use the range of value. Say that your own DC will be between the lowest and the highest, and you put the district value. You put the value here in that way, lowest and highest. So any value around that age, you can around that side, you can write it. You can put it as your missing value, it will capture it for you, capture them as missing value. But of course, that one looks confusing. This first option is better, look better. And it doesn't mean you have to use all the three of you. Can you use only one? Can you use only two? And you know the funny thing? Me, I don't use it. I don't even use non-missing value. The reason is very simple. For SP, if you look at it, it's put there as non-missing value at default. Me, I don't use the reason I don't use it. The SPSS, if we don't even do it, is to analyze the missing value separately for you, sir. I think it's more useful if the reason for your missing value is more than one. Yes, because of that, you can use this to separate them. But if it is just missing value, you feel that you don't want to analyze those reasons, maybe it's only one option that can cause the missing value. There's no point. Because the SPSS also will run the percentage of the one that are missing from you, which you have put as non-response. Now, that is that. Column, I've explained that. Right, alignment. Alignment just means, just like anything in your Excel, is it middle, right, or left? When you type, like if you look at it, when you type, like this one is aligned to the left. You want aligned to the right or the middle. But something, you can change it. You can change it, because it's center, you can change it. So when you are typing your data set, that's the alignment. I don't know what the use of that one, apart from aesthetics value. Now, there's something you discover. You see all of them are right now. The reason is very simple, because all of them are numeric. If there's anyone you change to string, automatically it will change to left. So let's try it. Let's say this serial number now. We remove it from numeric. You click on string, you click OK. Can you see automatically the alignment become left? So that's just it. Now, let's go to the measure. This measure, if you click on the option, so maybe I should allow you so that it can be interactive because somebody is talking now. I don't know, maybe somebody is sleeping now. Because some people can even go and take tea now. Oh, some people are always. See, most of us, somebody is warming food. So let's be interactive. Let's see. Can you see my icon? Who can explain what this one means? We will click on the option. Look at the option there. The option. Who can explain what that one? Okay. The option. If you over and you know. By default, you see unknown. But later, if you click on the option, can you see? Who can explain what this measure means? You can just talk straight, unmute yourself and talk if you want to explain it. What does this measure mean? At least let this team be interactive.
I think, I'm not sure, but I think scale has to do with if the variable is continuous.
Okay.
And then ordinal is when you they are in order, they are ordered based on maybe degrees or something. And then nominal does not have any.
Be giving us example of issue. Give us example. You are doing well. Give us example.
Okay. So scale will be like then you maybe measure of something, maybe like blood pressure or something, I think.
Okay, go on.
And then ordinal. Ordinal will be like this education that we were discussing, or this ordinal is education. Then nominal will be like marital status, where there is no
order.
Sex.
Ethnicity, geopolitical
ethnicity,
zone.
Yes.
State.
Okay.
And what department, all those things, they are at the same level. There's nothing that says male is superior to female. There's nothing that shows that. There's nothing that shows one ethnic group is superior to the other. There's nothing that says one geopolitical zone is superior. You cannot arrange them. If you arrange it, maybe alphabetically just for you, for his state also. Just like Nigeria, the number one state is Abia. Because A, B, that's the, if you arrange it alphabetically. And the last one is Zamfara, because it's Z. It doesn't mean that Abia is number one, Zamfara is the last one. It's just for convenience. And I didn't arrange alphabetically. But if you want to list it according to population, you can rank. Yes, I'm not. They say the higher one or the low, middle one. The based on that population size, you can rank. So, but the state on its own is no ranking. But based the size, the population of the state, the size, population size, you can rank because there's order. You can have order in the high, in the middle, and low when it comes to population. Highly populated area, moderately. And low populated area can do that. So yeah, that's fine, you are right. And the nominal, you know that the simplest form is binary. There are two, like the sex, male or female, binary. So anything that is binary cannot be ordinal. Do you know the reason? Even if that was created from quantitative variable, even from ordinal variable, in as much as you have dichotomized it, it's nominal. For example, when blood sugar is an interval scale, but no, it's not interval scale, it's a scale, it's not interval scale, sorry. The ratio scale, but it's a scale. So the when you now say blood sugar greater than or equal to 126, say diabetic, yes or no. That's no nominal, it's dichotomous. As if those are diabetic, those are not diabetic. But there's nothing that say. The people that are diabetic are superior, the people that are not diabetic or whichever. So all the people that are not diabetic are superior. No, it's yes or no. That become diabetic, no diabetic. Now, let's the last one. The last issue you see by default, you see impute. Impute your mean. And it's just one of the variables, just only one of the variables in the study. But if you click on the option, look at the one I want you to usually look at is the last one, split. Split here means, are you going to use this variable as a split variable? For example, some of you, when you do your comparative study, urban, rural, public, private, you will see that when you analyze it, you have to analyze it like that. When you're running the analysis, there must be a variable that separates it, otherwise it will run everything together. You won't be able to. That's the problem many people meet. They don't want to wear that one. Yes, I think it's the understanding allowed to be. I remember when I was in Lut as a resident, none of the, well, don't let me be too detailed. There's one person abroad, is one of the lecturers also doing his PhD in the College of Medicine there. Body data, the data, something. He has given the data to them in the statistics department in the U lab. And the person, that also is a lecturer there in statistics. The person now entered his file. You know, he's doing comparative. He was doing comparative. He now entered the two data sets separately on, no, enter one in one SPSS file, enter the other one, and run this one separately, run generated the result for this one separately, and gave it to the man. The man, of course, will be confused than before. So he couldn't make meaning out. This is supposed to be compared. So the analyst just run some descriptive something, and I gave the output to the man. So the man now brought, now refer him to me. And I look at it and say, okay, the problem is that person, I forgot that. This study is one. You're supposed to enter into the same place. Then there will be one variable that will be split variable. So what I did was to now merge, to now put the other, put it together because it's the same thing. But I now created a separate variable, which is the group variable. If it is urban, this will be urban, they will be rural. So when I'm analyzing it, I want to run them parameters together. I would like that variable. I can set it here as split variable, ab initio. But you don't need to bother yourself to do that. That's why that one is useless. The option is the road. It's not useful. When you are analyzing, that's the way I would tell you under the data. You can split it. When you are no more split it, you can remove it. You can split it, and you don't want to split it. So those are the, so it just telling you the function of that variable. So I think we have explained all those things now. So you see that at the inception, when you are creating your variable, even before you enter your data, you have to set what they are. Those are the characteristics of the variable. Any question? So after you have created now, let me create more. Now, there's something, if you create something that is yes or no, like hard of TD, you want to say yes or no, you can come here and say one is yes, two is no. You can decide to say.
Please, can you open that window again?
Which window?
That one of labels.
Look, you just click on it. When you just click on that cell, you click on it, it will show you guys.
Okay, values.
Values, okay. Yes. And yes, so you can make it one is yes, no is zero. But there are two different occasions for using them. This one now, if you want to do regression, whether logistic or linear, you know that there any variable you can put in, even correlation. You know that it's a biserial and point biserial. Maybe we talk it's another level. When we get to correlation, what's of correlation, all the lecture of correlation, we talk about that. So you have to code one. If yes, maybe may have, you want to correlate, you can correlate sets. You know you can correlate. Then you have to choose one as one and choose one as zero. So if I want to correlate sets now, say if I choose male as one, female is zero, I'm trying to say male sex. What I'm actually correlating is male sex. But if I choose female, if I want to correlate female sex, I will choose female as one and may and code female as zero. So in that type of analysis, correlation, using for regression, you need to, for that automatic variable, either yes or no, two, you must, it must be one and zero. But if it is for general analysis, put, it's better you put one and two. Some people, they go ahead to just enter one and zero. But sometimes when they run an analysis, they enter into problem about calculating something. And now, if you do a 2x2 table down, and you want to do odd ratio from it and relative risk, if you go and code one and zero, you are just wasting time because the way the computer arranges it, those cells, when you do 2x2 table, those four cells, they have their address. When you say address, the function on each of them is different. A, B, C, they are different. You know that when you are calculating odd ratio, relative risk, A, B, C, D, they are different. They have their different role. So when you code one and zero, what you, it will make, put zero in front of one because alphabetically zero come before one. It will switch. You will be thinking your yes is one. That first one is yes, one. And the second one is no. But it has swapped it for you. Make your no, which you think second one as one, as first one, and this one as second one. So it, that's for all the, even when you are doing something like, maybe you are calculating specificity or sensitivity, whatever, for diagnosis test. If you do that also, you will be confused. So that is why the conventional one and two is better. But when you want to now do that type of analysis, you use, now you can change it. You can create another one for it. Can create the number, just a matter of say, this one one, this one zero. Very soon, you just give the command. So for it, so that we create the dummy. We talk about dummy later. We now create the dummy. Dummy is what you create when it's the one zero. So it's not all the time you just enter your this as the form of dummy. It can give you, you can give you result, you say you are confused to interpret. Now I just say that one now. Now, another thing I want to say here is you can see we have different type of variable, quantitative, you just put a value there. If it's categorical and you want to code it, you want to make it numeric, you must talk about the value here. But if you don't want to make it numeric, you can type there, male, female, type it there. But it has its own limitation with some analysis. Like if you want to run ANOVA now, that particular, you know, you have a variable that gives you the group. If there are three groups, that three group, if you go and take it, urban, rural, semi-urban, and that's type that you don't want to code. When you want to write, you want to use it to as the group, you want to do another, you will not see that group variable, it will not even appear. Unless you make it numeric. So that is why it will make it easier when you make everything numeric. All it means that you are coding. But there are some few ones you will not code. Like if you say others, specify. That other, they are free to type whatever they want to type. So later you can now sort it out if you can see a pattern. You can now create another, do the, create a variable, now label it yourself. Now put value for those others. But in those situations, open-ended question, you allow people to type, you can type them. But apart from that, it's good to code them to give, leave them as numeric. Also, if you enter your data set with Excel, it's good to make it. You are likely not, your error will be limited if you type in, read, don't go and code it with Excel. It is when you are moving to Excel, you cannot come and do the coding. Because if you Excel, mistake is much, enter with Excel. It's better if you create the questionnaire file in SPSS and enter it. But the fastest, if you want to enter data, it's a painful. The error is limit is, if you want to minimize your error, to minimize, it's a painful, it's the best for entry data I've seen. Because it's not like spreadsheet like this. Because this one, there may be parallel error. But that one, in fact, if you are entering, if you are allowed to If I make mistakes somewhere, it will not go further. So they have given me a project before that. I analyzed it in the SPSS. They want, I called it, I created, I don't want mistake. I created the data file in a spin form. I trained people to enter it in a spin form. Later, I now converted it and analyze it with the SPSS and give the result to the company in SPSS. Since that's where they wanted, when they were entering, I used a spin form. I wanted to minimize error. So that is just that. So what I'm pointing out here is in entering your data, you code, but there are some things you have to be careful about coding. Where I'm going to now, the next one I want to a particular form of variable. Like for example now, all the variable here now, categorical variable, they are mutually exclusive. If you belong to one group, you cannot belong to another group. Sex, marital status, ethnicity, all this occupation, they are mutually exclusive. But there are some variables that come in form of independent life. Symptoms. Nothing, what are the symptoms? Either you ask this as a question, or you ask it as whether you have it or not. You experience weight loss, fever, vomiting, diarrhea. And you think of different headache, cough, abdominal pain, all those things. You are asking concerning a particular in your research. For the fact that somebody commonly can have all of them. All of them can be a possibility, can be possibilities. That's about symptom is independent. It's not mutual. So I should leave the symptom. For the fact that somebody has headache does not preclude the drain from having vomiting. So you will not create it as one variable. On your SPSS, go to one of them with a one line, one variable. So you're going to say, instead of typing symptom, you now see headache. Fever. Weight loss. And so on. It must be. So what you not give here is yes or no. Yes or no. Yes or no, maybe you can do one and two like that. And the way I look at the way I can copy this one, I can open it up and close it and copy. If I right click and copy, I can select this one, paste. And you see, automatically it has done it for them. You let it the decimal, reduce to zero. Because if you look at the decimal, the institute, you can see in the label, it will give you 1.00 because the decimal two places by default is there. But this one, I've reduced the frame right. Can you see? It's neater. So if you don't need the decimal, you reduce the decimal here to zero. So can you see? From this is multiple responses. This one says click as many as possible. That's the way you create this. Each of them is yes. Then if you create something like maybe weight now, you may decide to say maybe in the weight, especially in the weight of children, you give room for decimal. If you measure in kg, so you may decide to say, okay, for the weight that we want, let's not do. For height in meter. For height, got a full space before I put a space. For height in meter, you leave it at two decimal places. So I'm just creating many scenarios of creating. So when you finish now, you make sure you save home. If I don't save this, then you don't see it. So maybe what I will do now is that I will save it and give it to you. So tomorrow, in the before evening, try to enter something in your home. Enter something under the data view. Let me see. Any question about that aspect? Any question? If you have question, just ask your question. Oh, it's all clear? There's no question.
I don't have any questions.
Okay. So mute yourself if you are not asking a question. So let me save it as practice. 21. Yes, I've saved it. I will mail it to you. So you go, that will be your assignment. That will be the take-home assignment. Now, let's move further. Let somebody share that thing. Let somebody share his hand. Let's see, how do you share? How do you share? How do you import Excel? Something has been written, enter in Excel. You import it, and you now try to clean it. Let's do that one now. So that way, the two files I gave you, one is in Excel, one is in SPSS. The skin lesion is Excel. The SPSS is BMI. Now, somebody...
Did you send the file just during the session or you send it before?
It's today. I sent module. Okay, is there anybody I didn't forward it to? Because I think did you module the file for practice? Who did not respond that they are forward to you now? Who did not see? I didn't see
it. I have not seen it, but...
Okay, sorry, it's there. I mentioned that it's there. And what is it? You didn't see it? Okay, Dr.
Let me check my email.
Okay, that's Dami, right? Is it Dami that is talking? Is it...
No, Aisha.
Dr. Aisha, I sent it. Maybe you didn't check. It's after I sent...
Okay, I've seen it. Yes. The link.
Who has downloaded it?
Okay.
Who has downloaded it? Dr. Marty, did you download it? Somebody was telling me that she has skin lesion now. They has the fine skin lesion.
Yes, I did. It was
can you share? You can share your just click your SPSS and share the SPSS. Don't worry. We'll tell you what to do. Share the SPSS.
Skin lesion, or is it?
Yes, it's not like that. No, don't go to two ways. Open your icon, SPSS icon. Okay, don't worry. I want you to use one method now. Double click on the BMI. Double click on the BMI now. That BMI you are seeing. Is it not you that didn't install it very well? Is it not you that didn't install
yes,
it?
Yes, I was the one. Only one I have is this skin lesion.
You cannot open that thing. Double click on the SPSS, the BMI.
On the SPSS module.
That BMI. Yeah, double click.
Okay. Yes,
I don't think it will open because you didn't.
Sir, how do you want to open the file?
I'm coming.
It's not open. It's not opening, sir.
Hello, sir. My own BMI is not opening now.
I was actually talking, I was muted. Hello, Dr. Dr. Bolale, it will not work. So until you do the right.
Yes, until I do the right. I thought it was the skin.
So, Dr. Marty.
Yes, sir.
Have you opened your own SPSS?
Yes, I've opened my SPSS.
Okay, share.
I'm trying to open the BMI.
You don't need to. Okay, you know, how? Just share the SPSS you open. Share the one you open. Share with us. Don't worry.
Okay. I'm still trying to share it.
No, you see share screen. I'm going to share screen. When you say you go to see that,
I was out of Zoom.
No, you have to be in Zoom to share. Okay, yes, we can see.
Okay.
Okay, this is the SPSS file. That's the BMI, right?
I think so.
How do you think so? It's the BMI. Okay, that's fine. So how did you open it? I want to know how you open it, because there are two ways, as I've said. How did you open this one?
I don't know. I just double clicked from the email. That's all.
Oh, from the email. Okay.
Yes.
You have not even said. It's the download now. As you downloaded it. You just downloaded it now, right?
Yes.
Go and save now. Save as, so that you put it in a place in the document where you want to put it.
Okay, save as.
Look at where do you want to save it? We shall save it where you can see it. Because you are in download now. You are in download. If you want to save it,
yes.
Go put your arrow that go up. Come and see the arrow that. Let me show you. Look at this arrow. This one are in circle. Come and see. To look, okay, you have done that, yes. Look for the file, yes. Look for the folder.
I can see. I'm using two devices.
Okay. Yes, look for. A folder.
I can save it in download.
You want to save it in download?
I can just save it. Oh, okay, this one.
How do you save it in download? If we don't save it, it's in download already. So look for a place to save it.
Okay, I'll save it on my desktop.
Okay.
I'll save it on my desktop.
Okay. Okay, save it.
Abby?
And save it. But it was supposed to carry the title BMI. Maybe you change it somehow.
Okay. I can save it now.
Save.
Store file to repository. Or yeah. Save.
Just save.
Okay.
Now, this, we are not using this file. But if you look at it, it's just like the way you save it now, even if you close now. If you go to that place in the desktop where you put it, if you double click on it, it will open SPSS and open this thing, just like the way it has done. But what I want us to import the, but what of the SPSS, Excel, where did you put it?
I've just downloaded it, I've not saved it either.
Okay, you can stop sharing, go and save it. Go and save it, stop sharing. Ooh, Dr. Emesheta. Dr. Emesheta, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Have you downloaded it?
No, I said I can't download them. I'm just listening. I couldn't download.
Okay. You are not using computer. You are not with your computer.
Sir?
Is it that you are not with your computer? Are you using your phone to connect with us?
Yes.
Using phone, it's like listening to lecture. You are not in workshop. Because workshop will allow you to participate. Is it that you don't, maybe you have SPSS on your computer?
No, I said I couldn't download because my phone is, my laptop is Mac.
Was okay, so sorry, I forgot in Mac. Okay, I understand. You cannot even install yourself. Because you don't even need to download that thing. All you need to do is to, you know, it's from Google link. It's link. It's Google link. I put it because it's heavy. You can, so even with attach it, it's a big problem. A lot of this thing. So I put it in a Google Drive rather. Google Drive. It's from my Google Drive I share with you. You can even install it from the Google Drive. That is, you open the Google Drive without downloading it. You install it. It's only that you only need to copy out. The only thing you need to download from it is that crack. When you download the crack, so that, and that one is very simple to download, it's very small. Then you'll be able to finish the installation. So like Dr. Bolanle, how did the easy that you downloaded, you just install it from the Google link, Google Drive. Dr. Ozonwa. Doctor, if you are talking, you have to unmute yourself. You are muted. You are muted.
I'm sorry. I was trying to do what Dr. Aisha, Dr. Dami did. I was trying to see if I could just open it straight up from my mail.
It's not possible. You are SPSS. She was able to because you already installed SPSS. You cannot do that. The SPSS is not installed properly, so you cannot do anything with it. But what I'm just asking, I was asking something. Where was I asking itself? I forgot it. You are making me to forget. Okay. you are laughing. Dr. Aisha. Dr. Aisha.
Yes, sir.
I know that you have downloaded it too now. Both you have saved them. Now share
the BMI and the skin lesion.
Share that your window with us. That SPSS you wear. If you have not closed, just share what you have with us. Share anything you have with yourself. So what is there that we want to go there? You can go on.
Sorry, I cannot find the SPSS. I just saved though.
Where you want to save in desktop? Well, you don't need to go to. Don't you have documents? When you go inside document. You inside document, you can even create folder and say workshop and I'll save it. Yes. Can you see now? You also, you went to download, doctor. Don't share download with me. I don't want the download.
Share. Don't you open it from my mail?
Don't open. What of the SPSS you opened the other time when we're in practice? Have you closed it? Share that one with us. We don't want this. Share that one with us. It's out to the connection and knock out. Okay, she's back.
Hello.
We are listening to you.
Hello.
Share that screen. Do you want to share?
I lost connection.
Yes, we saw that. We saw that you went out.
Okay. Yeah. So I should share the screen again.
Yes.
Can you use my screen now?
It's coming. Yeah, that's not coming. Yeah. Why is it slow now? Why is it slow now? It has not been slow before. Close, what happened? It has not been slow. When you were sharing,
I don't know what's wrong with my network.
Maybe it's your network. It's slow to come. It has come now. We have seen it. Now, you have this by virtue of the fact that you have opened this file. You are in XSS now. Yes. Now, want to import Excel into XSS through this file. It doesn't have to be that file. It can be blank XSS. It can be the one that has data file, just like your own. Can be blank one, can be this type. So go to file. People should be following. Go to file. Click on the file now. It has, we didn't see you, it has stopped sharing. She's out. She's having connection problem. And I want you to do it because that's the only way you can learn it. I can share it here. You are out and in again.
Yes, my network just is doing sudden.
Okay.
Should I share again?
And share now.
I've shared on the network.
But we are, yes.
It's unstable.
Okay, yes. I just wait. Erico. Is coming.
My this thing is not saving now.
What is your?
It's not saving. I've tried it twice now. It's not saving.
It's you that you didn't try. You didn't do it very well.
Ah. I've tried though. I've put it in. I tried to put it in a folder and put it on my documents. I'm still not seeing it. I've saved it twice and I'm not seeing it.
It's you that you don't know where you put it.
This is the folder I created. The SPSS workshop folder is still empty.
Is it that you are loading?
Hello?
Wow. We're supposed to just open directly from the mail.
I'm not even sure I understand it.
Hello. Hello, can you hear me?
We can hear you.
We can hear you.
Okay.
Good. Okay, can you, sorry, Dr. Mechete, Dr. Karim, just wait. Dr. Dami was having issue with, he doesn't know how to save from download. Hmm? Let me just show
no, that. No, I know how to save. I know how to save from downloads.
Hey, you know how to save. Why did you say you save somewhere and you didn't see it?
This thing, the SPSS file, the BMI file. It's not saving.
Forget about that. It's saving. Or should I download the same thing? Let me go to my and download the same thing and show you the way it is. Just wait. Let me go to. I'm in my mail now. Can you see? Can people see?
Yes.
Can I see my mail? Let me, the same thing I sent to you, let me go to send. Well, I send the thing to you. Modules and file. This is the one. So now, two ways. What you have done, I don't know. The way you downloaded it. You know, I forwarded it to you. Well, I first sent to these people. Can you see now? If I try to download all these three now, can you see? It will download in a folder. Yes, I'm not like a zip. When you open the zip, I'm opening the zip. Can you see? If you can you see the zip I open?
I can see it.
So here now, two ways. I can even copy all these three. Not digitally. I copy all these three and right click. Right click and copy like this. Copy to the file to clipboard. Clipboard. When you copy, you can go and look for just trace. How do you go? You trace, you can come back to your distance and trace. You open, it's only that I'm not seeing it here, which I can, unless I stop sharing.
I'm sorry, I can only just see a blank page. I can't see anything here.
Yeah, you cannot see anything.
It's a blank page we're looking at. Yes, the page is blank.
Can't you see some file here?
No.
Okay, maybe I know I need to reshare it because it moved. Can you see it now? Can you see some file?
Yes.
What really happened is that the email I was sharing, immediately you open, so it's the email that is still showing. So that's why. So now what I did, you can copy. When you download all of them together, it will download like that. If it's that one you target, it will go and open it, download. Yes, I'm not. For example, if it's that one you target now, I can go back to that one. Don't worry. You copy this one now. You just go and open a folder and paste it there. But if it is, let me go to my email. Not this one. And look at the email now. Can you see the email now?
Yes, I can see it.
If let's say I decide to download the SPSS version, any of them separately, let's say the BMI. Can you see that immediately? That you see, can you see the icon there? Can you see?
I'm looking for the icon.
Is that
okay?
One,
yes, I can see it.
Lower icon here. You see the icon?
I can see it.
If I double click on it, it will open the SPSS. Since I have SPSS installed, you see now, it will open it. Just like the other time. It's opening. Maybe it's slow, small, because I opened too many things. Then it's opening. Let me stop. Share. Maybe it has opened. I don't know.
I've actually sorted it out.
It has opened. Sorry, it has opened many times. Sorry. It has opened many. Let me share now. It has opened. So let me share it. You know, it's because of the something. It has opened. Look at it. Can you see? It will open. When it open now, it's not saved unless it's in only in download. Yes, I'm not. It's only in download. So you now go to file. When you say file, you now look at save as. You save it somewhere. When you say save as, you know it will be in that. Can you see it's in download? Because it's in download. You now click on, can you see that icon? You look for other file. Can you see? or you even go through this page. If you go through this page, like me now, my document is in D, and I now look for a place. I can decide to go and put it, and now look for any folder, or I create another folder. You understand me now? So me now, I'm using for looking, but maybe I've created a folder. Like now, under the Zoom meeting now, I can say, under the online course, I can now put it, I want to put it under data. Or I can create another folder here. You understand me now? We have data, under data, I look for a place to put it. Look at data file, right? I have this BMI already here, can you see? I can call it 2, so that it won't replace the other one. You save. So you want to put it, it's in desktop, because it's difficult to look for something in desktop. It's there.
It's not in desktop, but I've sorted it out. Thank you, I've seen.
How did you sort it out, okay?
I saw my mistake. I went to download. I think I was opening from the email. So I went to download and I saved it from there.
Okay. Okay, can you share? Where? Who will share now? Can you now share proper now? What of the Excel? Have you saved that one also?
I have saved the Excel.
You know where it is. You know where you put it.
Yes, I know where it is.
Okay. Share. Okay, go open.
This is the BMI.
You are sharing something now.
This is the BMI one.
Uh-huh. Now, go to file. People, you are seeing it now. Go to file of the BMI. File.
I've already saved it though.
Don't worry. I say go to file.
Okay.
And that's open. Go to open. That second one, open.
Okay.
You want to open something else? Go to data.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Now, if you look at it now, it took you, where you save this BMI, is it the same place you save your Excel?
Yes.
The reason you are not seeing it is because what you want to open is in Excel and the format here is SPSS. So the arrow, you see this arrow here. Let me bring my annotation. Look at this here. Look at this arrow here. Click on it.
Which arrow?
I'm showing you with a pen. I'm using a pen. Click on it. Click on that arrow. That's the one that
I can't see the pen. No.
I can see your arrow. Click on that arrow you are clicking on. Change this thing from SPSS to Excel. Mm-hmm. Yeah, click. Click on Excel. You went to portable something. Click on it. Change to Excel. Now you are. Click on it. Can you see immediately? You can see the skin lesion in Excel format now.
Yes.
Click on it and open, or even double click on it, it will open. Uh-huh. But did you click? You didn't click on it now. You didn't select it now before you open.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Oh yeah, open now. No, click OK. Let's see.
Okay, I think it's still open on my other.
If it's open there, you can open it here. Go and you have to close it. You know, it's the same data, so you want to. It's open. It's being used somewhere. Go and close that one. Have you closed it now? You have to go out. You don't need to. You are just.
I've closed it and I've.
Go back now. If you have closed it, go back to the
I've
file.
I've closed it.
Go back to the file.
Okay.
Click on it now. Do the same thing you were doing. So go and do send to Excel. Click on it and open. Wait. In that you read variable name from the first row. Yes. Just click OK. It will come up now. Unless if your RAM is very small. It's slow, slow. But you're having small RAM.
Okay.
Yeah. Can you see? This is, no, we have not. It has not opened.
It hasn't opened.
It has opened somewhere. Yeah. You know, come out of this and go and share. It has opened somewhere. It's because maybe your RAM is small. It will
have opened. I think maybe somebody else should share.
You see your life now. So
my internet connection is even failing.
Okay, maybe that's one. Okay. Stop sharing. Dr. Abdul Karim, share that thing. If you don't participate like this, you will not know anything about it. Dr. Abdul Karim, are you there?
Yes, I am. I have shared my screen. Can you see it? Is that my network is messing up.
Sorry, my network went off. No, Aisha, we can't see your screen now.
We can see it now.
Okay, yes, we can see it now.
Okay. I was trying to save this BMI into a folder in my documents. After doing it, I did not find it there when I went to check my documents later. Hello, can you hear me? And messing me up. Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Hello, Dr. Gro.
Yes.
Hello, I can hear
you. Oh, is that Dr. Abdul Karim?
I was trying to. Yes.
Yeah, you have shared, yes. Go to file.
I've opened file. Open. I see.
Yes. Click on open. Click on that open. The arrow that you give it to open data. Click on data.
Okay.
Now click on data. Click it now so that it takes you to the window of data.
Yes, I'm on it. It's data.
Go and look. You know where the folder, where that your SP, your skin list. Where is the file folder? Where you put the skin list on? Where you save it? Look for it.
It's still on my desktop.
Now what for all of you? Desktop. Okay, you can look for desktop here. That arrow that in front of document. Click on it. Oh, no.
Yes, I am. I'm on desktop.
Okay. You try to access your desktop from there. You are here. You're on desktop now. Now, where is it? You put inside a folder of bed or it's just black on desktop? Answer me. Is it inside? It's just a hand. We will not be able to see it until you change this thing. Come to this arrow here, down here. You change it from SPSS to Excel. You won't be able to see it. Yeah, click.
Okay.
Click on that arrow. It will give you option.
I've clicked on it.
Click, go to Excel now. You are in Excel now yet. Then go and be checking your desktop, you see it now. Go to that, if you have clicked on Excel. Yeah, go to this, go to that arrow on that desktop. Yeah, I'm going to check it now. You see it.
Okay, I've seen it now.
You have seen it?
Yes.
Yeah, click on it.
Yes, I've seen it.
Yeah, click on it and open. Click on open.
Okay. Open. It's saying read the Excel file and it's showing me.
It's not showing us. It's not showing. Maybe you stop sharing and share again. We can't see. It's not showing us. Maybe.
Okay.
It's not showing that.
I'll share again now.
It's not showing all that is
shared. I see
it. It's coming up.
I saw that I'm sharing again now.
Yes, you can see now. Can you see?
Hi.
Oh, yes, just click okay. Just click okay.
Okay. I click OK.
Yes. Click OK now and yes. Can you see? It has read the
Excel.
That's how to read Excel. Using Excel. But if you look at it, it doesn't have Title 2 yet. So what you do is
that's what I'd like to say.
Uh-huh. So what you do now, go to File and Save. When you just save it and when you log out, you won't see the SPSS format. We are just reading it. Go on, save as. Save as. Save as not open. Go to save as.
Yes, I'm going to save as.
Okay, I think your internet is slow, so I didn't get it on time. Yeah.
Okay.
Give it a name. You can still call it Skin Lesion. Skin Lesion. No, look at
the document.
Fine name. Look at fine name here now. Oh, you want to put this on your document?
Yes.
Okay, make sense.
Can I put it in a folder in my document?
Yes, you can do that.
So click on the folder. I have a folder, SPSS.
Go and click on that folder so that it will be inside before you save. Go to that folder.
Okay.
Open it. You have to open the folder. Open the folder.
You
double click on it. Go back and double click on it. It's because you want to select it. Go back there, double click on the head. Can you see that?
Okay.
So now go to save now. Save.
Yes.
Save.
She's saving as SPSS.
Yes, I've saved now.
Yes, now. It will save it as SPSS now. Yeah. You see now it has title. The SPSS has title.
Yes.
Uh-huh. So let's stop here. Tomorrow, we first of all clean. See the way we go to work on this Skin Lesion. The one you are converted to SPSS now. We start our descriptive statistics from it. We get all those on it. We start with it. Many, many things. The transformation, coding, all those things. We start with this file. Any question? Any question?
I have a question, sir.
Go on.
Yes, sir.
No.
So this, if I have any file now, any Excel file on my laptop that I want to bring to SPSS, I'm just going to follow this procedure that we went through.
I didn't even hear what you're saying. This thing, your voice is breaking. What did you say?
Okay, I said So it means that once I have any Excel file on my laptop that I want to bring import to SPSS, I just follow the steps that we just went through.
Exactly. That's how to read or import Excel into SPSS. You know, in research, people are different level. Some people, they want you to help them analyze now. And that's okay. Have you entered your data is in SPSS? They didn't know. And can you, as I said, they don't know Jack. They don't know how to enter. But can you put it in Excel? They say, yes, you can. Somewhere. They put it in Excel, okay, let them send it to you. When you put it in Excel, you read it in SPSS, you save it, they are now make your do the cleaning, the coding, everything. So that's all it. Any other question?
Sorry, can Aisha share the screen again for what she has? Because what I have here, I'm looking at my folder. I don't know whether this is the Excel one or I don't even know what this is. Aisha, please, can you share? Can Aisha share that screen again?
Okay. Aisha, please, you should share the screen.
See my screen now.
Okay, share your. Let okay, Aisha. Let us share our own.
Okay. Network is poor. Yeah, that's right. Okay, let me stop sharing.
Let us share our own so that we can see what she has. It's the same thing I share sharing now. It's the same thing now. Because it's the same thing I attached, you downloaded. Your EPS is not the same time I send it to you. Now, you may say that something may change because it's not as if anything change anyway, but the arrangement may change small. So, Dr. Marty, what's the problem now? Dr. Marty.
Oh, sorry. Hello, sir. Yeah, sorry, I put myself on mute.
Yeah, you are muted. I say, what is the problem? Do you understand now?
I understand now. I wasn't sure. You know, when I stopped sharing, my Excel did not load. My Excel did not open.
Okay.
So I wasn't sure whether it had opened or not.
But you are sure now.
Yes. So I can now save it the way Aisha saved it, Abi.
Exactly.
So I'll still go to save us.
Yeah. Is it not skin lesion you are supposed to put there?
Oh, skin lesion. Sorry, I'd forgotten.
That is the title of the file now.
Yes.
Save.
Okay.
So, it has a title now, Abi?
Yes, it has a title now.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Any other question? Okay, if there's no other question, Dr. Uzonwa.
Sir.
Any question?
No, sir.
Why? Is it because it is clear or because it is confusing?
It's because I couldn't, since I didn't download all of that, so I think.
Because that one is not option. I give you two options. Now that you don't have questions, is either because it is clear or it is confusing. The root cause is what you want to say. Though I'm not asking for the root cause, I want to first of all diagnose first. Is it because it is confusing?
I really don't know if I'm confused now or I've assimilated too much since I could not practically follow up. So that's what I wanted to explain.
Actually, this if you don't do it with your hand, you can't be sure if you know it. Because in the process of doing it, if you know it, you make mistake. It's by making mistake, you know it. Now do the right thing. That's why it's always good. So go on. Follow that thing and deinstall and now install and follow the instruction.
Okay.
The letter. You usually miss that one, that step. They say you uncheck, you didn't uncheck, you just pass. You didn't follow that step 8. You understand me now?
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. I'll try and do it and
okay.
Get to pass, yes.